This is, I still have my... Oh, do you want the microphone? I used to have this beautiful girl living next to me. She came and, she's still there. But she came to ask me if I knew how to fix a hot water heater. I thought, this is it! This is how the people meet in the movies. You know, I'm going to get with her because she's single and I'm single. And this is how it's going to happen. And so I went and fixed the hot water heater. And then found out she had a boyfriend upstairs. And what was he doing? Yeah, exactly. See, you understood my feeling there. But this is ridiculous. So you know what I did? You know, I wrote a song. Yeah, I wrote her a song. That taught her a lesson. Now I have to think of how it is. I think it's this pickup, Tom. I think it sounds like crap.
Oh, who asked me if I knew how to start a gas hot water system? I thought, this is fantastic, this is just how people meet in the movies. It was dark and she was attractive, but I tried to look complacent as I followed her into the yard under her house. It was all dirt, the beams were so loaded that I hit my freaking head on one.
I wrote it down in case I forgot. And here they are. Now, I just need somebody to read them out to me. All right, so I've gone into the house, I've hit my head, it actually started bleeding and I was freaking out, but I had to persist because I wanted to get with this girl. And when I say get, you know what I mean, don't you get with, you know.
Impress.
But yeah, with that. Yeah, impress, yeah. I
tried to look cool, said nothing had happened, but my head hurt a lot and I swore a little bit. Trying to crouch in the dirt to look at the hot water heater, only light we had was from a mobile.
That's a really tricky bit. If anybody wants to do that bit, you are quite welcome. I've never been able to manage to do it.
Nice guys fumble in the dirt on the bus that gets to go and he gets to watch television.
Nice guys
get what they deserve. They just spend their time long instead of reaching out for what they want.
It would have been cool to be charming and my head hurt a lot, and I know I knew what I was doing. Soon became clear that she knew more than I did. So I read the instructions, and I felt a bit stupid. The story's absolutely true. My life is what you call a painful existence.
No hot water meant no happy ending.
So I kept pressing buttons until the pilot light came on. She was delighted, and I was surprised. She spoke of hot showers as I wandered out to the yard. Thanks very much, I have a friend upstairs, but he is more hopeless than I am. Then I realise I'm just a bunny next door, and all of my thinking's been wishful. Well, I've been downstairs, bleeding in the dirt, I've been upstairs watching the TV. Feet up on the couch and dishes in the sink, and no further effort required. Oh no, there's an epilogue. Oh, thank you so much. It's like you can't wait for it to be over, I love it. Is it finished yet?
Nice guys fumble in the dirt while the bus gets the girl and he gets to watch television.
Nice guys who get what they deserve, they just spend their time long instead of reaching out for what they want. Nice guys fumble in the dirt while the bus gets the girl and he gets to watch television. Nice guys who get what they deserve, they just spend their time long instead of reaching out for what they want. What are you two talking about?
Have you got a joke? The hard bit.
The hard bit. Can you see my heartbeat? It's the woman that I had a child with, and so we've been at loggerheads ever since, and I think is that a common story? Does anybody else have that?
That's how it works.
That's how it works. That's fair enough. Good. So I wrote her a song, because she used to crawl into my head, and I'd think, well, get the hell out of there. And she wouldn't go.
No, you've got to sing it.
So I tried to sing her out.
Yep.
She's still there.
Keep singing.
Oh, I'll do that, sir. I'll do that. Hey, this one's for you.
Darling.
My girlfriend moved into my head. I know there's a lot.
about. My insecurity packed into boxes and stored at the back of my mind.
Did anybody notice I fucked that bit up? No, you didn't notice. Packed all the baggage in the front part of my head and left it there for me to come a cropper over on. You'd think that I'd have more respect. She'd have more respect for somebody else's head. If a thinking man saw, are there any thinking men in the room apart from Clinton? Oh, bullshit.
Bullshit, nothing.
Come on, give me some deep. Oh, forget that. I almost got into a deep intellectual conversation with you. So my girlfriend moved into my head. Oh no, hang on. I've forgotten that bit. Don't forget I said anything. Everybody's looking at me, it's freaking me out. My girlfriend unpacked all the baggage in the front part of my head and left it there for me to come a cropper over on. You think that I've had more respect for somebody else's head? Okay, we've done that bit, that's good. Sounded great in my bedroom. You really should come over. You think that she'd have more respect for somebody else's head? But no, fuck that. I didn't write this bit down, so don't panic.
It's alright.
It's her fault.
Hey, can you make something up? Just fling it my way.
You need the glasses to see it.
No, it's not even there to see, but you're so kind to see it. I'll give you the general gist.
Yeah.
She moved into my head and you think she'd have more respect, and she didn't.
You started tripping over all the shit.
She just started tripping over all the shit.
Yep.
And then that's it.
Well, where is she now? What happened?
You'll find out, sir.
Yeah, right. Stick it the song.
We'll just abandon this bit and get to the next bit. I like to get out of my head. Now it's so quite crowded up there. I watch the things I say. I watch what I think to, and she can read thoughts too. I like to get out of my head. Talk to whoever's there, like Clinton. Clinton's sitting there thinking, this is fucking awful.
He's thinking, how's he going to follow this guy? That's what he's thinking.
Where do I get to go on? This is bloody awful. How much time? You want to go on now? What am I? I could just sing one more.
Yeah, we'll do one more.
One more? What?
Yeah.
I came all the way here from Ipswich. Alright, one more. I've got to pick a good one. Okay, I was looking at buses, you know, bus watching on the street. It's like train watching, but it's what we do in Ipswich. There is trains there, but the buses are so attractive. And then I thought, nobody actually knows where these things go. You know, that they could be whales on the road for all we know. We don't know where they go, you know. You just catch a bus, just in pot luck. It might be going to the, you know, to the Royal Brisbane Hospital, it might not. You've got no idea. Nobody can read the schedules, like, especially at Garden City. Ever go there? It's a maze. Not even the bus drivers know where they're going.
Buses are wild to the road, and nobody knows where they go. No, nobody knows.
Buses are wild to the road. Buses are wild to the road. Buses are wild to the road.
Buses are wild to the road.
No, 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 no. Buses are wild to the road. Nobody knows where they go. Buses are wild to the road. Nobody knows where they go. Whoa,
whoa, whoa. But there's an asshole at the front, there's an asshole at the front.
An asshole at the front, an asshole at the front. There's a seat at the back, a bike at the back, a loony in the middle, and an asshole at the front. And buses are a mystery, a mystery to me. That is to say, I have no idea which ones they want to leave, but there's a select troop of people who seem to find just there and when the buses go. I'm sure it's so, that's how they say in the know. There are a bunch of assholes in the front, there's an asshole in the front. Asshole in the front, asshole in the front. There's a seat at the back, a bike at the back, a loony in the middle, and an asshole at the front. And buses on nails and road.
Did I say nails in the road? I think I said nails, but just forget that. It's written that way. I was just following the script.
And nobody knows where they go. No, nobody knows. Buses are wild on the road. 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 No, 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 no. Buses are wild on the road. Nobody knows where they go. Buses are wild on the road. Buses. Nobody knows where they go. Oh, oh, oh. Why didn't Bob Dylan ever fuck up? There's an arse on the front. There's an arse on the front. Arse on the front. Arse on the front. There's a scene at the back. A bike at the track. A loony in the middle. And an arse at the front. And I think he's trying to get me to fall over. I'm sure he's trying to get me to fall down. I think he's trying to get me to fall over. He's a bus driving clown. And there's two types of bus drivers. There's loonies and arseholes behind the wheel. There's two types of bus drivers. There's loonies and arseholes. That's what I feel. This is like an act in itself, isn't it? Can anybody see Tom's bottom? How does it look from there? I'm sure he'll know then. That's not quite so. I think that's right. Yeah, I'm never quite sure. Buses are wild to the road. Alright, I think that'll have to do it because Quentin's got to play and thanks very much. We can, you know, we can pack one
guess
more.
Guess what? You were right. I got on a bus once at Alderley going to Chermside, yeah. And the bus driver had no idea where he had to go. I had to direct him part of the way, and the other passengers told him where to go.
Oh my God! You got a complete psycho. You're lucky he didn't abduct you. That's horrific. Well, you need a song. I've got a song for you. Clinton, do you want to just, while you grab your stuff, I'm just going to sing this lady very quickly. Is that, no, you grab your stuff.
I don't
want to
get in the way.
Yeah, no, you do. You do. Oh, I'm not playing then. Thanks very much for listening. Clinton's up next. Thanks very much, Tom, for organising with you. Thank you. And I love this place. I love your place. This very, did you do that? Is it yours? Did you do the decorations?
Oh, yeah.
Did you?
Yeah.
Clever girl.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.